Morning, everyone.
Ooh, I need gas.
It is the 29th of October. It's been a while since I made a video, I know. But I haven't done anything. The van has been sitting in the driveway, I unpacked it, and that's it. That's all I did. So, it's getting fairly cold now. I mean, it dropped down to near freezing last night, or the night before. And so it's starting to make me a little nervous, because I haven't winterized the Queen yet. However, my folks really want to take a trip together before I put her up for the winter. So today we are heading to Elkhart, Indiana, to the Motorhome RV Hall of Fame. Actually, today we're heading to the campground nearby, and then we're going to the museum tomorrow. But potato, potato. So yeah, that should be fun. So, my folks are behind me. They got their RV and their granddaughter, my niece, in there. And we're going. I decided not to bring Frank along this time because it's only an overnight trip and it's kind of hard on him to change his routine like that. If I were going for more than, say, if I was going for, say, 2 days or even 3 days, I'd probably take him with me, but for just one overnight trip, it's just not worth it to him. So I let him stay home, left him plenty of food and water. He'll be fine. So we're gonna stop and get gas because I have no gas. Also, my dash cam seems to be working. What happened was, before the trip, the long trip earlier this year, I misplaced the SD card. I brought it inside to take video off of it and somehow misplaced the little micro SD card. I mean, they're only that big, you know. So it vanished. I thought maybe the vacuum had sucked it up or who knows. So I bought a different one on my way out of town, just a smaller one. And apparently something is wrong with the other one, the one I bought. It doesn't agree with the dash cam. Because now that I found the original SD card and put it back in there, it's working fine. So that's good. So I don't need to buy a new dash cam. Also, I wanted to talk a little bit about what is this van really worth? I've been getting a lot of people talking to me about it. A lot of people thinking I complain too much about how much money I've spent. And some people are saying, I don't think it's worth more than 10. I think 10 is really ideal. I don't think I'd expect to get more than that. I don't really think I could get even that much. Other people are saying, some people are saying it's worth as much as $30,000. No way, no way. I'm sorry, it's just not. If you disagree with me, offer me 20. If I got an offer for $20,000, I'd take it. So if you think this thing is worth that much, by all means, make me an offer. Okay, we're here. We are at the, I don't know if I said it earlier, we're at the Elkhart Campground. Elkhart, Indiana, the Elkhart Campground. And this is our setup. There you go. See, we got the queen over here, and we got my dad's nice RV over here. This is a beautiful RV that it was my fixing up the queen that inspired him to sell that crappy old one that I showed you before and buy this really nice one. And while his is much nicer than I will show you this. See that? It's been sealed up before, it's been leaking, and it's all rotten in there. So we have to fix this. That is the inherent problem with Class C's. They almost all leak above the driver. I don't know what it is about that section above the driver's seat that just leaks, man. Always does. So we are going to have a nice fire and relax. And tomorrow we're going to go to the RV Motorhome Hall of Fame.
Come on out, baby girl. All
right, cool. Morning, folks. Sorry I didn't get more video of the campground itself. It got dark a lot faster than I expected. And, well, long story short, basically we're getting out of here fairly early this morning. So, it's a very nice campground. Good size. It's about 4 acres, I think, or maybe, no, it's gotta be bigger than that. Anyway, they've got a pool. They've got a little mini golf course. They've got a playground for kids. Very nice campground for what you pay for it. And they also got cabins. So if you don't have an RV, they have cabins here for you. So definitely worth coming if you're in the area. So now we're heading to the RV Motorhome Hall of Fame. So should be interesting. This is cool, look at this.
No! No.
Look, it's painted like a motorhome. It's got tires on it. Travco. We got an old van over here.
This one, 1979.
Yep, 79 Chevy van, StarCraft. Looks like it's got a couple of seats and a table in there.
It's kind of see better from the back.
Oh, is it ever cute?
These are actually brand new units that are designed to look old.
Is that right?
Yep, these are vintage style, but brand new inside.
I love the tires.
Me too, white walls, I love white walls.
Me too, I love the white walls.
Did you hear what I said? This is brand new, even though it looks vintage. It's designed to look vintage.
Oh, look at that. That's cool. Look at this, Dan. They make it retro.
I love it.
It's cute.
It's so 50s. That's so sweet.
Dinette.
Yeah.
You got a modern fridge. Modern three-way fridge.
What's it got in the bathroom now?
In the bathroom, we have a flush toilet with a shower.
It's got a shower?
It sure does. It's right here. Just like the one in my van.
I love this color.
Very small, but you could sit there and shower.
Oh, it's all I need.
I love the color.
Hey, as long as you can clean up.
Absolutely. More seating back here. You got full water pump, water heater, electric and gas water heater. You got all the amenities in here.
Yep.
Gas stove and microwave. Now, this is an actual vintage trailer made by Shasta in 1954. This is the company that made my father's old motorhome, the one that I showed you in my second video. So this is legitimate vintage. As soon as they're done, I'll go in and show you. creaky.
Ooh. Kind of creepy.
We got a hammock deal going on here. That's interesting.
Hey, that's
look at that.
Clever.
And then down there, I'm guessing that folds up maybe into a couch, perhaps. You got a sink here.
Everything has to fold up.
Yeah, here you go. You got a water tank, and it's just a gravity feed into the sink. Although you do have a faucet.
This has got to be an icebox. Yep.
Yep, not an actual fridge, just an icebox. That's very cool. And you got a little stove, though. It's dark in here. The wood absorbs all the light.
Well, there's only a tiny light there.
Oh, there's one back behind you, too.
Wow. Still, better than a tent.
Oh, absolutely. And over here we got a new trailer. StarCraft, is it? Is this? No.
I don't know.
Yes, it's made by StarCraft. It's the StarCraft launch.
Big window, that's right.
My mother's really into big windows.
Sink.
Oh, very nice. See, they're making these much more homey with the fake marble countertops and so forth.
Uncle Gordon, go look in the sink. That's very interesting.
In the sink in the back?
Yeah.
Once again, the sink.
Look in the sink!
Oh, they've got antifreeze in the sink.
Ew.
And no drain. But you got a full bathroom with a toilet and a tub. A little skylight over the tub there for natural lighting. I'm surprised they put in a full bathroom in this little trailer.
Notice it's got no carpeting.
Yes, they're finally wising up to that one.
Far superior.
Yep, I'm going to get rid of my carpeting too. I'm going to do something like this in mine. See, a nice hardwood. Well, a fake hardwood anyway. But notice how much space is taken up by a huge bed, and they got a dinette instead of a couch. There's no good place to relax in this trailer.
You relax on the bed.
And who wants to do that all the time? Well, that's because you're lazy.
Yes.
Between them.
Now look at the storage in this next one.
Yeah, this one has a whole house underneath it. This is a Winnebago Vista. Look at the size of these storage compartments.
This
but
is
not pass-through.
This is bigger than
so cool.
This is huge. Look at this. My God. Well, see, if I owned it, that is where you'd be living.
You'd have to put a slot in the door to pass me food.
What makes you think I'd feed you? More storage down here.
Wow.
Man, this is huge. It's even bigger than the one on your RV.
Well, way bigger.
This is a Class A.
It's so amazing!
Oh,
in here.
I think Serenity likes it.
It's so amazing!
Is it amazing?
Look
at! Wow, look at that!
This is nice. This is a slide out.
Yes, that's why it's so big. We got a slide out.
So you can live with your
that comes down.
Yep, we got a bed up above the driver.
Yeah, this is pretty nice.
I'll be the driver today.
Are you going to be the driver, Serenity?
Yes. Beep, beep. Or I'll just crash into the window. This is the shower, but this
hold
is
on,
the
honey,
bathroom.
Hold on. See this? Does this so you have privacy while you're in the shower.
Yeah.
So you're not showering
it's a divider.
Out in the living room. That makes sense. And then, then you've got the stool and the sink in here. Very nice.
Oops,
Randy. Okay, so then you got the bathroom here. Oops.
You know what you don't have back here?
Closes here.
You don't have, if you like to watch TV and bet you don't have a place to put your TV. I guess you could hang it on a wall.
Yeah, you could.
The only problem with this is that if you're traveling with multiple people that aren't very intimate with each other, if somebody's sleeping, nobody else can shower.
No, that's true. Well,
this is a fifth wheel. This is a really nice one.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. They got a raised living room in this. This is beautiful.
This is the advantage of the towable unit. You get so much more space.
Well, see, they changed the design of the fifth wheel. Normally, the bedroom would be up here, and the living room would be back here.
This is nicer.
This is beautiful. I love the raised living room.
Are you allowed to ride in it while it's being towed?
No.
See, there you go.
Yeah.
Well,
that's the downside to trailers.
Look at the size of it.
Yeah, you got a fireplace.
It's a house.
This thing is beautiful. Absolutely beautiful.
Nice. They've even got a wood.
This gets towed by a big truck.
They've got a double-doored wood panel.
This
look at the size of this fridge is bigger than the one at home.
So you just can, like,
it's pretty
big. You can hook a car on it and you can take it around.
Yeah. A big truck.
A big truck. Like here, honey, that truck, like, right over there, like that black one.
Let me show you something.
Here's your living, your bedroom. Lot of storage space. Look at this. You got a. Oh, here's your bathroom. I see. You got two doors going into the bathroom, which is very nice. Nice design. Big shower. Look at the size of this. Wow. Beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. And your bed here. In a slide out. This is a slide out right here. This is the vintage motorhome room.
1913. Look at this. 1913. 100 years ago. Wow.
That was fancy for the time.
And that is fancy for them. Look at how it's beautiful.
It's actually got cabinets and stuff in it.
Behind the Model T.
No, it was a Model T. Oh no, that's wrong. It was towed with a Model T. It's a trailer. I thought it was built onto a chassis.
Oh, look at that. Is that?
There's another one.
1916 telescoping apartment. Sold for $100 in 1916.
And it adds look right to the back of it.
Look at that. Yeah, it mounts to the back of the Model T and it pops out backward and then sideways. So it comes out so that you can sleep, and then this pops out so that you have your kitchen area.
It does.
Your bed area. And then your storage area. That is freaking brilliant. Oh, wow, look at that. Mounted right onto a Model T. Look at that. That is genius. It's funny. As much as I love RVs, I want the Model T. Of all things, I want the Model T. Yeah.
Warm water for shower produced by radiator heat from the engine.
Get out of here.
It had a warm shower.
Wow.
Nice.
1958 Airstream Flying Cloud. You got a really nice couch, like an actual couch from a house, which is very nice in a motorhome or in an RV. And full kitchen. I can't really see what's around the corner. I think that's a fridge. I think I see a toilet back there. I sure do. There's a toilet way back there. Wow. 1931 model double. Oh, I'm filming myself. Brilliant.
It's called a house cat.
1931 model
house car.
Double A Ford house car.
This is a Model A.
Tennessee Traveler.
It's even got a pot-bellied stove in it.
It sure does. It has a little stove, a little wood stove. Get out of here. You have wood seats for driving. Oh my gosh.
Wow. What?
You got a little a propane stove over there. And a bench seat in the back. This was very fancy.
Look at the pot belly.
I see it. I can't believe they actually put a wood stove in this thing.
Gotta have heat.
Look at all the woodwork. How beautiful the woodwork is.
This is 1931, honey.
Whoa, this is amazing.
1958 Airstream. I can't even pronounce that.
Little Prince.
Yeah, let's call it that. You got a little couch here that looks like it folds out into a bed. You got a furnace standing right there. You got a full shower. And you have that horrible toilet just like mine. Oh, it's got that horrible recycling toilet just like mine.
Didn't realize those had been around for 50 years.
I didn't even know they existed before I bought mine. If you lean in there, you can see it. It's back there. It's awesome. This here's a 1954 Holiday Rambler. What is with the coloring in these old campers? It's very 1950s. Yep, you got storage.
1950s risque.
You have... you have twin hammocks. So I guess for two kids. Sleep up there and one adult down there. And you got your refrigerator. This is an actual refrigerator with a little freezer. It's even got the little ice trays. Oh my God, it's cold. They got it turned on. It's actually cold in there.
I'll be darned. It's working. It's all plugged in and working.
That's funny.
Wow.
Oh, man.
How's that for well built?
Yeah, back then.
60-some years old and still running. Find me a fridge today.
Yeah, good luck finding an RV fridge today that works for 60 years. Here's your 1950s risque right there.
Diane,
very cool.
You want to know how well built?
1957 Scotty 10-foot teardrop trailer. Teardrops are very popular. They've got a whole cult following.
This is a little bit bigger than my bunk in the forecastle on the apple bar. I'm serious. It's a little bit bigger.
I believe that.
The shelves, and that's about it.
Yep. So all you got is a little bed. It didn't even have any built-in lights. They had to put this light in there. And then around back, you got your little galley. It's a little wash basin, little stove. Isn't that cute?
Cooler. Jeez.
Perfectly comfortable.
Yep.
Absolutely fine. It fits me just fine. Plenty long enough.
More comfortable than what I was sleeping on last night.
Yes, but this
$500. Right. Yeah, the back window on the van is apparently still leaking because the bed was all wet last night. So I slept on the couch. 1966 Mustang travel trailer. You got the aluminum body. It's actually a pretty good size.
I like the all aluminum.
Me too. Pardon me.
You can just sit, but it's, you can't slide in this part. Very hard.
It's got a...
Now this is interesting. What have we here? We got a couch thing back here, but then there's this. Look at that.
Is it a second bed?
It's a second bed. And you walk around here, and there's even a little ladder back there. I guess this is for the kids.
Could be, or doesn't matter, adult.
A little bit of space. Gives you a little bit of privacy, the way they built this.
Mm-hmm. And it uses the space, three-dimensional.
Yep.
So you double your use of space.
Very, very cool. Oh, little Dometic fridge. Gas electric. This was very fancy in the day. Yep. This was very fancy back in the day.
Look, if you go up here, you go up there. Go up. See, it's got a... Look, it's got a bed up top. Isn't that cool?
Yep, and you got a full bathroom.
Isn't that clever?
With a shower and everything. Shower and toilet. It's got a real toilet. Even mine doesn't even have a toilet. Look at this old one. This is nice. Look at the shape this is in. No, this is, well, it's got the round headlights. I'd say late 70s. I could be wrong, though. Have a look here. '78 Coachman Leprechaun. This is the old version of yours. This
sure
is my father right now is driving a 90 what?
99.
A 99 Coachman Leprechaun. Yep, full bathroom.
Here, Gordon, look at this.
Oh, look at that. Oh, wow, look at that. Look at what somebody put in.
So it slides?
Yep. Got the AC/DC VCR TV combo. Back in the day, that was so fancy.
Mm-hmm.
Nowadays, it's just more electronic crap.
Well, look at the nice swiveling chairs.
Yep, swiveling seats. My mother's all settled in.
It's actually comfortable. You wouldn't have to pull the dinette.
Full refrigerator.
Oh, I love the fabric.
And this folds down. So it's not in your way all the time.
And you got the part up top. You got air conditioning. This has everything that our motorhome had.
Notice they're smart on this one. It's got comfortable chairs rather than those straight up dinette chairs they put in now.
Mm-hmm.
The table folds down when you don't need it, so you have a living area rather than just a stock. You're sitting like this in on a really uncomfortable
right.
bench seat all the time.
But you're giving up a bed. That's the only downside.
That's true. But you have this over
the end.
Right.
Bed,
you got this
got bed,
you got that bed.
Oh, there's nothing in the back.
Nothing in the back. Got the
no,
bathroom in the back.
Nothing in the back.
No, I mean there's no bed.
This is just way cool. I thought this thing right here was a trailer. It's not. It's a motorhome.
This thing has
look
got to be so
at
unique.
This. Look at the look on that thing. You can't even tell which direction it's going. Isn't that funny?
Oh, this is like something.
All right, let's
space.
Figure out what this is. This is what I was talking about earlier, how they were going for that space age look back then.
Yeah.
1937 Hunt House car. One of several vehicles built. By Hollywood movie cinematographer and producer Roy Hunt. Do they let us in it? They don't let us in it.
They don't let us in?
No, they don't let us in.
Cool. It's got a bus steering wheel.
It's got a steering up there. You got a stove and sink right here.
I love it.
And you got seating and a bed back there. Absolutely
this window rolls
fantastic.
Down.
Oh, it does.
What a design. And you got a bathroom in the back there. Look, you got a little porta potty and a fold down sink. Isn't that great? Look at this. I can't get over the design of it.
Pretty.
It's. Can you imagine seeing this thing going down the road back in 1930s?
You know what it reminds me of? Gru.
It does. It's like Despicable
it like
Me.
Gru.
It looks like Despicable Me. It looks like Gru's car. Isn't that cool?
Maybe they unlatched. Yeah, this is not a.
Now this is
a permanent.
This is a Class C. It almost looks like a pickup bed camper, but if you'll notice, it's actually a motorhome. It's built out of a pickup truck, out of a Ford F-250, and it's actually been molded together into one piece. Now let's see what it is. It's a 1969 Stites chassis mount truck camper.
For the
let's go have a look at this. Here's your water fill and your electric hookup.
That's nice and comfortable up there.
Big bench seat for driving. Oh, I gotta sit in this bench seat.
It's got the,
oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
It's got the amenities.
Oh, yeah.
Get that one over here. You got a bathroom or a shower?
Oh yeah, I could drive this thing all day. This is great. Look, I got this huge door on the side here. Oh man, this is so cool. I'm in love with this thing. You got that huge hood out in front of you. It goes for like 3 miles. I love it. I love it. I love how everything from the hood back is all handmade. This is so cool. Oh man, I love it. Oops. All right, I'm done. Oh man. Not exactly easy to get in and out of the bench seat though. Oh boy, let's see what's back here. Okay, you got a toilet and a sink and shower.
Need light again?
Sure, why not? Nope, that light doesn't work, but toilet. Sink and shower. And back here you got your full living area with the stove, sink, bench seating. I'm guessing this all folds down into bedding areas and a refrigerator. It's got everything you need. Actually surprisingly roomy.
Mm-hmm.
And a bed up top. More roomy than mine, no question, but I'm guessing mine gets better mileage.
Yeah.
1968 Jayco Jayhawk. This is a very early pop-up.
They're pretty much still the same.
Yeah, they haven't changed much, have they? You still got the seating in the beds, and this one's actually fancy. This one has a fridge or an icebox. And I don't know, I would have thought it'd be an icebox.
60s? Who was getting ice still in the 60s?
I don't know.
Late 60s, you couldn't even get ice anymore. That is the big blocks. That's this one.
And now we have the coupe, the pièce de résistance. What is this? 1974 GMC. These are very nice motorhomes in their day.
Front wheel drive? Based on the Cadillac Eldorado with the 455.
Get out of here. I didn't know that.
The Eldorado had a front wheel drive back
then. Wow. Airbag suspension, providing extremely advanced ride and handling for its day. It is the urban assault vehicle. Let's have a look here.
These were fancy.
We already been in here, and it's cool.
All right, I got to sit in the driver's seat.
Why?
Because I do.
We always do.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Excuse me, Serendi.
Look at the curved glass. You got this beautiful curved glass here leading all the way around you, so it's like you're in a spaceship. Oh.
An 8-track.
8-track player. Herb Albert and Tijuana Brass.
That was one of my dad's favorites.
Oh man, is that appropriate for the time.
Notice the levelers?
Oh yeah, look at that.
Power levelers back in the 70s. That is cool.
My favorite part of this is the stairs cleaning.
And you got
here.
Air conditioning.
That's my favorite part.
Fuel, main and auxiliary. Battery normal, battery boost. That's interesting. This is cool. I like this. This is very cool. Here we go. Okay. Whew. And then you got your sink and everything.
You got your electronics.
You got your full refrigerator with a full-size freezer.
Ow! Had an Onan generator in it.
Really? Hmm? Yeah. Look at that. It sure had.
Is your air conditioner up here?
You got more seating back here for those who don't want to mingle with the rest of the family. Full bathroom, I'm assuming?
Yep, it's a wet bath.
Yep, wet bath. Could use some cleaning.
Mm-hmm. But it had the full bath.
Yep. And there's your thermostat for your heater right there. All right, cool. Very nice. It's 1957 Winnebago.
67.
That's right, 67. This was the RV that made Winnebago synonymous with RVing. And now everybody talks about, they see an RV, oh look, it's a Winnebago, you know, it's like Kleenex or Jacuzzi.
That's what Chip kept calling ours.
Yeah.
Only has a 6-cylinder engine in it.
You got a bed up here. Cool seating down here. Okay, I gotta sit in the driver's seat. Okay, here we climb in here. There we go. Look at the size of the steering wheel.
That is your basic.
Except doing it up, kind of, they did it flat. That's kind of weird.
And huge. Look how. Yeah, it's the brake is like a foot away from the gas. You gotta raise up way up here to get to it.
Oh my goodness.
That's wild, and the steering wheel is huge. I feel like a munchkin sitting in here.
And that very attractive carpet from the 1960s.
Oh yeah, gotta love the 1960s styling.
And you got, a
full wet bath with a toilet. See, they had toilets back then, but they still couldn't figure it out for mine. But they could do it back then. They couldn't do it now. That's the part that annoys me so much. Thermal panel. Must be inside the walls.
Must be. Big closet.
What the heck is all that? No
AC/DC. It's got an AC/DC switch.
Wow. Huh.
Another bed up here. This probably turns, yeah, I can see this turns into a bed, these slide out.
Yep.
Fairly common at the time.
And a fridge. Yep. Very nice. All right, we're gonna take a look at this Travco. They said we could go inside.
1978, Gordon.
Look at this, will you?
Shag!
Shag carpeting. Oh my gosh. Look at this. Look at all the... Now, it looks like these... Serenity, no, Serenity...
Yeah, don't sit on the tables, honey.
It looks like you unhook these, and these fold down and become two couches.
Yep. Hey, that's kind of clever.
It is.
It's got a CB radio.
That was very 70s.
Oh, very.
Pardon me, Serenity. I gotta sit in the driver's seat. It's obligatory.
The generator has 555 hours on it.
Yeah. Look at the shifter. Look at that. Huge clunk, 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 clunk. Well, somebody put in a CD player. I'm guessing that's not stock. Big windshield. I love the big windshields.
Like, look at
you see the African queen way over there.
I'm very happy with ours.
I am too. Yeah, I think you're exactly right.
There we go. Come on over here. You got a nice big galley.
Very 1970s upholstery.
They need to clean these things.
Oh.
And refrigerator.
It's got a separate shower.
Are you there? Okay.
Toilet and sink and shower on this side.
Stove, or a closet right here.
In the 1970s.
Yep, toilet and sink 70s? Here.
70s?
70s.
70s.
And you said shower over here? Yep, yeah, well, wow, look at that. Oh, that is nice. I like the window. Gives you a lot of light in here. And you got your push-up vent right here.
I'm guessing it gets pretty chilly back here.
Well, that's the problem I have in mine. I have, you know, the same kind of thing going on with the vent in the back. Even though it's butting up against the back wall, it just goes straight down onto the bed. So I have to close this back vent and just have it blowing forward.
Little icicles on you when you wake up,
basically.
If you want to sit here and chop vegetables or something.
Yeah, this is very nice.
Well, folks, that was the RV Hall of Fame. It was quite cool. A lot of good stuff in there. She said, the lady at the front desk said that they actually have more, but they've run out of room, so they're going to expand next year. So that'll be cool. Maybe I'll come back next year after they expand and see what else they've got on display. Brought the African queen up to the front doors and took some pictures of her with the museum in the background. That was kind of cool. Anyway, we're heading back north now. We're gonna stop in Kalamazoo and hit Red Robin. Yum! Waiting for my folks and my niece to come out of their RV, and we're gonna go in and have some food. You know, while I was driving, a minivan pulled up next to me for a second, and then as I looked over, there was a woman looking at me, and as soon as she saw me look, she turned away, and I saw her mouth to the guy next to her. Oh my god, it's a white guy. Which means she read African Queen and expected a black person to be driving it or something like that. I just... Okay, African Queen may not be the most politically correct thing in the world, but quite frankly,
anybody who associates automatically thinks anybody anything referencing Africa is automatically referencing black people, that's ignorant. So if anybody thinks I'm racist for writing African Queen on my van, I put forth that you, therefore, are the racist for associating black people with Africa. Maybe that will ruffle some feathers. Frankly, I couldn't care less. So we're gonna go get some food.